The Philippine ICT Department warns recent cyber attack attempts on government websites are not ordinary. This comes as House Speaker Martin Romualdez called for an immediate briefing from the agency to address the attacks allegedly perpetrated by Chinese hackers. Among those targeted were the websites of DICT, the Philippine Coast Guard, the Philippine Congress, and the Justice Department. DICT Undersecretary Jeffrey D. notes the attempts were more complicated compared to previous hacking incidents, but he says there is no concrete evidence linking the Chinese government to the hacking attempts.
We were able to detect a command and center sa isang computer na nasa loob ng China Unicom Network. Ang China Unicom naman is a telecommunication service provider na nag-ooperate sa China. We will have to coordinate, of course, with the Chinese governments as we do. Pag-aari ito, 100% ng Chinese government.
The Philippine Defense Secretary vows to protect the country's sovereignty against a proposal by former President Rodrigo Duterte to create a breakaway Mindanao Republic. Secretary Gilbert Teodoro says the National Defense Department will secure the integrity of the country's territory. The Justice Department echoes this sentiment and calls on the public to reject secessionist ideologists. As for the Philippine National Police, it says supporters of Mindanao secession are being monitored.
Yun ang mga tinitingnan natin, those who are talking about such interest of separatism, yun ang may minomonitor natin.
Sabi niyo, sir, minomonitor niyo for possible violations yung mga grupo at this point sa Mindanao, whether magiging seditious ang mga panawagan or violent. Tama ba, sir?
That's right.
Experts clash as the Philippine Senate opened discussions on economic charter change. Sherry Antores reports.
Framers of the 1987 Constitution and economic experts give contrasting views regarding resolution of both houses number 6, which proposes to relax the Constitution's national patrimony and economy, education, science and technology, arts, culture and sports, and general provisions. During Monday's hearing, former Chief Justice Hilario Davide warned members of the Senate Constitutional Amendments Committee discussing charter change would be very dangerous for the people.
Devils will have the day when angels fly away. That amendments to or revision of the Constitution at this time would be a lethal experiment. It would be a touch a dance to the grave or to hell. It would be a cruel punishment for a God-loving, patriotic, and nationalistic people. God forbid that we now amend our Constitution.
Davide's stand is in contrast to that of retired Justice Adolf Ascuna, who welcomes economic cha-cha. But should senators insist on doing the task via constituent assembly, Ascuna gave this reminder.
Economic policy should not be put in a constitution. What is the procedure to change, to amend? You have the CONAS, says Congress, by a vote of 3/4 of all its members, may propose amendment or revision of the constitution. You can call for a constitutional convention by a vote of 2/3, again, of Congress, and we call a constitutional convention. Or to a people's initiative, which is much controverted right now, where you have signatures by the 12%. This is not what is sought to be done here. You don't have to meet jointly. There's no requirement for a joint hearing. There is no requirement for a joint voting either.
Retired Justice Vicente Mendoza asserts that although CONCOM delegates forgot to clarify the voting process in the Constitution, CONCOM records clearly state that Senate and the House of Representatives should vote separately on cha-cha.
Yung pag-uusap po ba sa pagitan ni Commissioner Suarez at ni Commissioner Regalado na kailangan joint session, voting separately, kapag ang napagkasundoan ay bicameral ay nasa record ng Constitutional Commission o pribadong pag-uusap po ba yan?
In the event that we adopt a bicameral Congress, we will insert the word
joint assembly, the votes of the two houses counted separately.
Minutes before the discussion kicked off, Senator Robin Padilla filed resolution of both houses number 7, aiming to insert the words both houses in joint session assembled, voting separately in the Constitution Section 1 or amendments or revision provision. Lawyer Christian Monson meanwhile insists to the panel to touch on the anti-political dynasty provision of the Charter.
I request the Senate to initiate the passing of an anti-dynasty law, which is long overdue by 36 years, and to amend the party list system that politicians abuse.
This early, some senators are questioning RBH 6.
Yung sinasabi nilang restrictive, restrictive, di umano, hindi po yan totoo. Bukas na po ang ating tindahan. Kaya huwag sana nating gawing collateral damage ang konstitusyon.
I am also puzzled by the list that has been provided for public services, given the many problems we have had with NGCP.
House Deputy Speaker David Suarez hopes Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri will keep his word for the upper chamber to approve RBH number 6 by the end of March. But panel chairman Senator Sani Angara is targeting an October deadline.
Sa akin naman ang pinaka-deadline yan is yung filing sa October. Kasi by then, siguro COMELEC will need to finalize. Kasi kung ipasa namin ito, kailangan may plebisito tayo. Eh. So kailangan masama yun sa election. And yung most economical is masama siya sa 2025.
Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
An advocacy group supporting the ideals of the 1986 People Power Revolt in the Philippines wants to stop attempts to amend the country's constitution. The call was made by the EDSA campaign network ahead of the 38th anniversary of the revolt that toppled President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Human rights lawyer Shel Jocno insists no one should be allowed to exploit the constitution to serve their political interests.
Imbis na pag-awayan ng cha-cha, our leaders must address the real issues our people have to face every single day. Ang sobrang pagtaas ng presyo ng bilihin, hunger, poverty, criminality, corruption, lack of income and employment, and access to fair and equal justice.
Over now to Davao region, where the death toll from floods and landslides has risen to at least 21. The fatalities were recorded in the provinces of Davao de Oro and Davao del Norte. Thousands have been displaced. Power is also out in some flood-hit areas. Local authorities appealing for help as they admit their standby relief goods have already been depleted.
Ang province is talagang in dire need talaga yung immediate need nila ay pagkain. Kasi yung naipamigay namin dahil nga sa napakaraming affected na population is ang kaya lang talaga for the meantime para ma-answer ang need ng pagkain ng 117 more than na affected population is yung good for 2 days.
Now, catastrophic flooding also swamps Los Angeles as a deadly storm pummels Southern California. At least 2 people were killed by wind-toppled trees in the coastal Santa Cruz Mountains. A state of emergency has been declared in 8 counties with a combined population of over 20 million people. More than 500,000 homes and businesses also without power. The severe storm system began moving through the state last Friday, delivering a deluge of rain up and down the coast. Let's now get an update on the weather from our Pagasa forecaster.
Good morning, Ms. Bethina, and to all of our audience in ANC. Currently, easterlies is affecting the eastern section of the country. Because of easterlies, we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Davao region, Caraga, and Soxarten. Better weather condition is expected over Metro Manila and the rest of the country, where isolated rain showers or thunderstorms is expected. We don't have any gale warning raised over any part of the country, but those who will be traveling over northern Luzon and the eastern sections of southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao should be careful because the wave height may be moderate rough. we're not monitoring any low pressure area inside the Philippine area of responsibility, nor any tropical cyclone. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center, Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Veronica.